you, O Lord, to pour your grace into our hearts, that as we have known the incarnation of your Son, Jesus Christ, by the message of an angel, so by his cross and passion we may be brought to the glory of his resurrection. Through the same Jesus Christ, our Lord.
Amen.
Lord, open our lips,
and our mouth shall proclaim your praise.
Glory to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit, as it was in the beginning, is now, and will be forever. Amen. The mercy of the Lord is everlasting. Come, let us adore him. Be joyful in the Lord, all your lands.
Serve the Lord with gladness, and come before his presence with a song. Know this, the Lord himself is God. He himself has made us, and we are his. We are his people, and the sheep of his pasture.
Enter his gates with thanksgiving. Go into his courts with praise. Give thanks to him and call upon his name. For the Lord is good. His mercy is everlasting, and his faithfulness endures from age to age.
The mercy of the Lord is everlasting.
Come, let us adore him. Psalm 16 and 17. Protect me, O God, for I take refuge in you. I have said to the Lord, you are my Lord, my good above all others.
All my delight is upon the God, the Abiter in the land. From those who are noble among the people.
But those who run after other gods shall have their troubles multiplied.
Their libations of blood I will not offer, nor take the names of their gods upon my lips.
O Lord, you are my portion and my cup. It is you who uphold my lot.
My boundaries enclose a pleasant land. Indeed, I have a goodly heritage.
I will bless the Lord who gives me counsel. My heart teaches me night after night.
I have sent the Lord always before me. Because he is at my right hand, I shall not fall.
My heart, therefore, is glad, and my spirit rejoices. My body also shall rest in hope.
For you will not abandon me to the grave, nor let your Holy One see the pit.
You will show me the path of life. In your presence there is fullness of joy, and in your right hand are pleasures forevermore. Hear my plea of innocence, O Lord, give heed to my cry. Listen to my prayer, which does not come from my lips.
Let my vindication come forth from your presence. Let your eyes be fixed on justice.
Weigh my heart, summon me by night. Melt me down, you will find no impurity in me.
I give no offense with my mouth as others do. I have heeded the words of your lips.
My footsteps hold fast to the ways of your law. In your paths my feet shall not stumble.
I call upon you, O God, for you will answer me. Incline your ear to me and hear my words.
Show me your marvelous loving kindness. O Savior of those who take refuge in your right hand, from those who rise up against them.
Keep me as the apple of your eye. Hide me under the shadow of your wings.
From the wicked who assault me. From my deadly enemies who surround me.
They have closed their heart to pity. And their mouth speaks proud things.
They press me hard, now they surround me.
watching how they may cast me to the ground.
Like a lion greedy for its prey. And like a young lion lurking in secret places.
Arise, O Lord, confront them and bring them down. Deliver me from the wicked by your sword.
Deliver me, O Lord, by your hand. From those whose portion in this life is this world.
Whose bellies are filled with treasure. Who are well supplied with children and leave their wealth to their little ones.
But at my vindication I shall see your face. When I awake I shall be satisfied beholding your likeness. Glory to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit. As it was in the beginning, is now, and will be forever.
Amen.
The first book of Samuel, the 17th chapter, beginning at the 17th verse. Jesse said to his son David, "Take for your brothers an ephah of this parched grain and these 10 loaves, and carry them quickly to the camp of your brothers. Also take these 10 cheeses to the commander of their 1,000. See how your brothers fare, and bring some token from them." Now Saul and they, and all the men of Israel, were in the valley of Elah, fighting with the Philistines. David rose early in the morning, left the sheep with the keeper, took the provisions, and went as Jesse had commanded him. He came to the encampment as the army was going forth to the battle line, shouting the war cry. Israel and the Philistines drew up for battle, army against army. David left the things in charge of the keeper of the baggage, ran to the ranks, and went and greeted his brothers. As he talked to them, the champion, the Philistine of Gath, Goliath by name, came up out of the ranks of the Philistines and spoke the same words as before. And David heard him. All the Israelites, when they saw the man, fled from him and were very much afraid. The Israelites said, "Have you seen this man who has come up? Surely he has come to defy Israel. The king will greatly enrich the man who kills him, and will give him his daughter and take his family free in Israel." David said to the men who stood by him, "What shall be done for the man who kills this Philistine and takes away the reproach from Israel? For who is this uncircumcised Philistine that he should defy the armies of the living God?" The people answered in the same way, "So shall it be done for the man who kills him." His eldest brother Eliab heard him talking to the men, and Eliab's anger was kindled against David. He said, "Why have you come down? With whom have you left those few sheep in the wilderness? I know your presumption and the evil of your heart, for you have come down to see the battle." David said, "What have I done now? It was only a question." He turned away from him toward another and spoke in the same way, and the people again answered him as before. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God. The second song of Isaiah. Seek the Lord while he wills to be found. Call upon him when he draws near.
Let the wicked forsake their ways, and the evil ones their thoughts. And let them turn to the Lord, and he will have compassion. And to our God, for he will richly pardon. For my thoughts are not your thoughts, nor your ways my ways, says the Lord. For as the heavens are higher than the earth, so are my ways higher than your ways, and my thoughts than your thoughts. For as rain and snow fall from the heavens, and return not again but water the earth, bringing forth life and giving birth, seed for sowing and bread for eating, so is my word that goes forth from my mouth. It will not return to me empty, but it will accomplish that which I have proposed, and prosper in that for which I sent it. Glory to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit, as it was in the beginning, is now, and will be forever. Amen. The Acts of the Apostle, the 10th chapter, beginning at the 34th. Peter began to speak to them. "I truly understand that God shows no partiality, But in every nation, anyone who fears him and does what is right is acceptable to him. You know the message he sent to the people of Israel, preaching peace by Jesus Christ, who is Lord of all. That message spread throughout Judea, beginning in Galilee after the baptism that John announced, how God anointed Jesus of Nazareth with the Holy Spirit and with power, how he went about doing good and healing all who were oppressed by the devil, for God was with him. We were witnesses to all that he did, both in Judea and in Jerusalem. They put him to death by hanging him on a tree, but God raised him on the third day and allowed him to appear, not to all the people, but to us who were chosen by God as witnesses, and who ate and drank with him after he rose from the dead. He commanded us to preach to the people and to testify that he is the one ordained by God as judge of the living and the dead. All the prophets testify about him, that everyone who believes in him receives forgiveness of sins through his name. While Peter was speaking, the Holy Spirit fell upon all who heard the word. The circumcised believers who had come from Peter were astounded that the gift of the Holy Spirit had been poured out even on the Gentiles, for they heard them speaking in tongues and extolling God. Then Peter said, "Can anyone withhold the water for baptizing these people who have received the Holy Spirit just as we have?" So he ordered them to be baptized in the name of Jesus Christ. Then they invited him to stay for 7 days. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God. A song of Christ's glory. Christ Jesus was in the form of God,
but he did not cling to equality with God.
He emptied himself, taking the form of a servant, and was born in our human likeness. Being found in human form, he humbled himself, and became obedient unto death, even death on a cross. Therefore God has highly exalted him, and bestowed on him the name above every name, that at the name of Jesus every knee should bow, in heaven and on earth, and then on the earth, and every tongue confess that Jesus Christ is Lord,
to the glory of God the Father. Glory to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit,
as it was in the beginning, is now, and will be forever. Amen. I believe in God, the Father Almighty, Creator of heaven and earth.
I believe in Jesus Christ, his only Son, our Lord. He was conceived by the power of the Holy Spirit and born of the Virgin Mary. He suffered under Pontius Pilate, was crucified, died, and was buried. He descended to the dead. On the third day he rose again. He ascended into heaven and is seated at the right hand of the Father. He will come again to judge the living and the dead. I believe in the Holy Spirit, the Holy Catholic Church, the communion of saints, the forgiveness of sins, the resurrection of the body, and the life everlasting.
Amen. The Lord be with you.
And also with you.
Let us pray. Our Father in heaven, hallowed be your name. Your kingdom come, your will be done, on earth as in heaven. Give us today our daily bread. Forgive us our sins, as we forgive those who sin against us. Save us from the time of trial, and deliver us from evil. For the kingdom, the power, and the glory are yours, now and forever. Amen. Show us your mercy, O Lord,
and grant us your salvation.
Clothe your ministers with righteousness,
and let your people sing with joy.
Give peace, O Lord, in all the world.
For only in you can we live in safety.
Lord, keep this nation under your care.
And guide us in the way of justice and truth.
Let your way be known upon earth.
Your saving health among all nations.
Let not the needy, O Lord, be forgotten.
Nor the hope of the poor be taken away.
Create in us clean hearts, O God.
And sustain us with your Holy Spirit.
O God, you have taught us to keep all your commandments by loving you and our neighbors. Grant us the grace of your Holy Spirit that we may be devoted to you in our whole heart and united to one another with pure affection. Through Jesus Christ our Lord, who lives and reigns with you in the Holy Spirit, one God, now and forever.
Amen.
suffered pain and entered not into glory before he was crucified, mercifully grant that we, walking in the way of the cross, may find it none other than the way of life and peace. Through Jesus Christ, your Son, our Lord.
Amen.
Lord Jesus Christ, you stretched out your arms of love on the hardwood of the cross that everyone might come within the reach of your saving embrace. So clothe us in your Spirit that we, reaching forth our hands in love, may bring those who do not know you to the knowledge and love of you, for the honor of your name.
Amen.
Almighty God, you have given us grace at this time with one accord to make our common supplication to you. And you have promised through your well-beloved Son that when two or three are gathered together in your name, you will be in the midst of them. Fulfill now, Lord, our desires and petitions as may be best for us, granting us in this world knowledge of your truth, and in the age to come, life everlasting.
Amen.
Let us bless the Lord.
Thanks be to God.